Hey everybody, how's it going? In this series of videos, we'll be learning how to create and use classes within Python and how object-oriented concepts are applied within the language. Now, there's a lot to cover when working with classes, so I'm going to break these up into several different videos. We'll cover the basics of creating and instantiating classes. We'll learn about inheritance, class and instance variables, static methods and class methods, and several other topics. So breaking these up into several videos will allow us to focus on specific topics in each video. So in this video, we'll be learning the basics of creating and instantiating simple classes. But first, why should we even use classes? Now, this isn't just specific to Python. You can see classes being used throughout most modern programming languages, and there's a good reason for that. They allow us to logically group our data and functions in a way that's easy to reuse and also easy to build upon if need be. Now, just a quick side note, when I say data and functions that are associated with a specific class, we call those attributes and methods, and you'll hear me use those terms a lot throughout these videos. So when I say methods, I mean a function that is associated with a class. So let's go ahead and get started. So say we had an application for our company, and we wanted to represent our employees in our Python code. Now this would be a great use case for a class because each individual employee is going to have specific attributes and methods. So for example, each employee is going to have a name, an email address, a pay, and also actions that they can perform. So it'd be nice if we had a class that we could use as a blueprint to create each employee so that we didn't have to do this manually each time from scratch. So let's go ahead and create a simple employee class and see what that would look like. So to create a class, it's just as easy as saying class employee. Now I'm going to leave this empty for now, and if we just left it like this, then we'd get an error. So if you ever have a class or a function that you want to leave empty for the time being, then you can simply put in a pass statement and Python will know that you just want to skip that for now. So now we have a simple employee class with no attributes or methods. And I wanted to stop here because I wanted to explain the difference between a class and an instance of a class. So our class is basically a blueprint for creating instances. And each unique employee that we create using our employee class will be an instance of that class. So for example, if I said employee 1 equals employee and employee 2 equals employee, then each of these are going to be their own unique instances of the employee class. So for example, if I go ahead and print both of these out and copy and paste that there, and you can see that both of these are employee objects, and they're both unique. They both have different locations here in memory. Now, this is an important distinction because you'll hear me talk a lot about instance variables and class variables, and it's important to know the difference between those. And I'll go more in depth into class variables in the next video, but for this video, we're going to be looking at instance variables. So instance variables contain data that is unique to each instance. Now, we could manually create instance variables for each employee by doing something like this. So let's say we wanted employee 1 to have a first name and a last name. So I could just do employee1.first equals Corey, and then I could do employee last is equal to Schaefer. And I could also give it an email address. So I'll do employee1.email equals, and I'll just do the first name with the last name at company.com. And lastly, let's go ahead and add a pay onto there too. So I'll do employee1.pay, and we'll just do 50,000 there. Now let's give employee 2 some of these same attributes. So for this one, I'll just do test user, and then I'll do test user, and I will make that 60,000. Okay, so now each of these instances have attributes that are unique to them. So if I print it out, let's say I could print out the employee1.email, and I'll also print out the employee2.email. Oh, and it looks like whenever I gave these the instance variables, I forgot to make this employee2 here. So now let's run that. So now you can see that that email was created for each employee. But let's say that we wanted to set all of this information for each employee when they're created, rather than doing all of this manually like we did here. So we wouldn't want to have to manually set these variables every time. You can see it's a lot of code, and it's also prone to mistakes, just like I did whenever I forgot to change the to employee two. So we don't get much benefit of using classes if we did it this way. So to make these set up automatically when we create the employee, we're going to use a special init method. So now inside of our employee class, I'm going to create this special init method. Now you can think of this method as initialized, and if you're coming from another language, then you can think of this as the constructor. Now when we create methods within a class, they receive the instance as the first argument automatically. And by convention, we should call the instance self. Now you can call it whatever you want, but it's a good idea to stick to convention here and just use self. So after self, we can specify what other arguments that we want to accept. So let's go ahead and accept the first name, the last name, and the pay. And I know that we had email too, but we can create the email using the first name and the last name. So now, within our init method, we're going to set all of these instance variables. So let's do self.first equals first. And now I'm just going to do this for the rest of them as well. So I'm going to do self.pay or self.last and self.pay. And for the email, I can do self.email equals first plus, and then we'll put a dot between those, and then last, and then we'll add on to the end at company.com. Okay, so whenever I say that self is the instance, what I mean by that is that when we set self.first equals to first here, it's going to be the same thing as us saying down here that employee1.first equals Corey. Except now, instead of doing this manually, it'll be done automatically when we create our employee objects. Now, these don't need to be the same as our arguments. So for example, I could make this self.fname equals first, but I usually like to keep these similar if possible. So I'm going to go ahead and set that back to self.first equals first. Okay, so now when we create our instances of our employee class right here, now we can pass in the values that we specified in our init method. Now our init method takes the instance, which we called self, and the first name, last name, and pay as arguments. But when we create our employee down here, the instance is passed automatically, so we can leave off self. We only need to provide the names and the pay. So we could create these by passing in first, and we have to do this in order. So I will pass in all of the same information that we did manually down there. And for the second one, I'll do test and user, and I think I had that at 60,000. Okay, so what would happen on this line when we create this employee? The init method will be run automatically. So employee one will be passed in as self, and then it will set all of these attributes. So it'll set employee1.first is equal to first, which we passed in as Corey. Employee1.last equals what we passed in as last, and so on. So now that we have that init method in place, we can go ahead and delete these manual assignments that we made down here. And you can see by deleting that we got rid of a lot of code. So I'm going to go ahead and comment out those lines where we're printing the employees. And I'm just going to go ahead and print out the email. So if I run that, then you can see that still works. Okay, so everything that we have so far, like the names and email and the pay, are all attributes of our class. Now let's say that we wanted the ability to perform some kind of action. Now to do that, we can add some methods to our class. So let's say that I wanted the ability to display the full name of an employee. Now this is an action that you'd likely need to do a lot with a class like this. So we can do this manually outside the class. If I was to come down here and do print, and I could get the full name just by putting in two placeholders there and doing a format and saying employee1.first and employee1.last. And if I go ahead and print this out, then you can see that we got the full name there. But that's a lot to type in each time that you want to display the employee's full name. So instead, let's create a method within our class that allows us to put this functionality in one place. So within our class here, I'm going to create a method called full name, and we can do that with just doing a def of full name. Now, like I said before, Each method within a class automatically takes the instance as the first argument, and we're going to always call that self. And the instance is the only argument that we'll need in order to get the full name. So within this method here, I'm just going to take the same logic that we had down here and cut that out. And I'm just going to go ahead and return that. But we have to be careful here because now instead of printing employee one first name and last name, I'm going to use self so that it will work with all instances. So I'm going to do self.first and self.last. So now that we created that method, instead of printing like we did before, now I can just come down here and do employee1.fullname and print that out. And if I run that, then you can see that we got the same thing. And notice that we need the parentheses here because this is a method instead of an attribute. So if I left the parentheses off and printed this, then you can see that it prints the method instead of the return value of the method. So we're going to have to put those parentheses on in order to run that properly. So now we have full advantage of code reuse here. So instead of typing this out for each full name that I want to print, now I can just use that method. So now if I wanted to print employee two's full name, it's just as easy as replacing employee one with employee two and running that, and we get the correct answer. Okay, and one more quick thing that I wanted to point out here. Now, one common mistake that I see when creating methods is forgetting the self argument for the instance. So let's take a quick look at what that would look like if we left that off. So now, before I run this, if I just commented out this printing of full name down here and ran this, then you can see I'm actually going to remove these print statements here as well. Now, you can see that this runs without any errors. But if I was to try to run this method that we accidentally left self off of, then run this, then you can see that we get an error. And the error that we got was a type error. Full name takes zero positional arguments, but one was given. Now this can be confusing because it doesn't look like we're passing any arguments here into full name, but the instance, which in this case is employee two, is getting passed automatically. So we have to expect that instance argument in our method. And that's why we added self. So I'm going to come back up here to full name and put self back in. And now running this, you can see that it runs correctly. Now we can also run these methods using the class name itself, which makes it a bit more obvious of what's going on in the background. Because whenever we do that, so I'll do employee dot full name. Now when we run it from the class, we have to manually pass in the instance as an argument. So in this case, I'll pass in employee one. So you can see how these are similar, but not exactly the same. So I'm going to put these side by side just so that we can compare them here. So these two lines here do the exact same thing. But here, when I do employee one, which is an instance, and I call the method, I don't need to pass in self. It does it automatically. And when we call the method on the class, then it doesn't know what instance that we want to run that method with. So we do have to pass in the instance, and that gets passed in as self. And if I go ahead and print this out and run it, then you can see that it works just like if we were to print out the employee1.fullname. And I wanted to show you that because that's actually what's going on in the background when we run employee1.fullname. It gets transformed into this here, employee.fullname, and passes in employee1 as self. And that's why we have self for these methods. So I hope that makes sense to you. That's not extremely important to know when we're just getting started with working with classes, but we'll need to understand that in later videos once we start inheriting from other classes and things like that. So I figured it would be a good thing to go ahead and show you that now. Okay, so I think that's going to do it for this video. In this video, we learned how to create simple classes, the difference between a class and an instance of that class, and we also learned how to initialize class attributes and create methods. Now we still have a lot to cover in future videos, and we'll be going over more advanced topics. So in the next video, we'll learn about class variables and how they differ from instance variables that we saw here. But if you do have any questions with what we covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below, and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then there are several ways you can do that. The easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also, it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone who you think would find them useful. And if you have the means, you can contribute through Patreon, and there's a link to that page in the description section below. Be sure to subscribe for future videos, and thank you all for watching.